Hi guys, so here we are again at TechNiqueBricks.com today to build one of the first half 2015 LEGO Technic sets, the 42038 Arctic Truck. So we are going to build it live today. Yesterday we was building the 24 hours race car 42039, so you can find the video online or YouTube, and let's start it. So this is a quite unusual model. Sorry, let me take the sound. Okay, I started to hear my feedback. Okay, so this is the second biggest LEGO Technic set for this half. It's quite an unusual model. It's orange, which is nice, and has four tracked elements. It also has steering and a crane arm. It has also a cargo bay that we can lift, so it has a switch box to switch between these two functions, the crane and the tipper or the cargo bed. So that's basically what we can see here on the backside. You see the tilt bed, the crane arm, which rotates, goes up and down on the boom on the crane arm, and then you can raise and lower some cargo on attached to this winch. We have also suspension on the different track helmets, and it also has steering. You can see over there the motor box 8293, which has the power function elements required to motorize this set. So it includes the building instructions after you complete the model to motorize these functions, namely the cargo bed and the crane arm. And here you can see also the B model. It's a similar vehicle, but without the cargo bed and without the crane. So it's a shorter version. And then you have some kind of contraption that moves on ice and has some kind of antenna, as it seems. But the instructions to this one will be available online. They are not yet available, but they should be available pretty soon, since the models are releasing. And that's it. So let's start. Okay, you see here on top of the table also the new elements for the switch box, the driving ring, and the clutch gears that can attach the driving ring from both sides. They enter half stud deep on this, and the connector that goes in the center and allows or you can hold at one side or another to switch among functions. Okay, so let's start. You already know that we have the Q&A enabled, so you can raise your questions. I just see that there are already some. Let's take a look. Let me just finish this initial step, and I will take a look on the I will take a look on your questions. And this one should be faster than the model yesterday because it is somehow smaller. So the first clutch gear goes here. Oh, and by the way, another new elements introduced with this model. You see, this is the, we can call it 1L beam. It's kind of a ring that you can put into a pin to act like a spacer. By the way, this model includes also some other new elements. Let me switch the camera, but first let me see the questions, and then I will switch the camera to give a close up for these smaller helmets. So Vitor is here again. He was yesterday all the building session with us. So the Q&A is working, Vitor. Massimo. Hi, all. Hi, Massimo. And Alexandre is also online today. Hi, Alexandre. Okay, Alexandre is suggesting that the B model is what we call a snow cat. Yeah, probably. I'm not familiar with that nomenclature. I heard it, but I'm not sure. But maybe it's a snow cat. So let me switch the camera to show the smaller elements. Okay. Here we are at this some new elements, and suddenly, as far as I remember, it includes this pin with double axle. It's a 3-stud long helmet. It's well, not really a counterpart, but it comes in the sequence of this other axle with double pin helmet that was released in 2014. Now we get also this version. This has been so far only released in dark bluish gray, and the new one in black. We know that the Technic pins get kind of a color code, so these are the colors for these helmets, and again now at a larger size for you to see this 1L helmet that's very useful to act like a spacer around the pins. And then we have also some other helmets like these panels. They are not new, the mold, but they are new in this color. And the same happens with one of the orange beams. I think it's this one. I'm not sure anymore, but I think this one was not released in orange before. And then, of course, the driving ring helmets that I mentioned before. So let's move on. We are building the central part where the it articulates, but we'll see that more in detail ahead. And now the first pin the pin double axle, which is quite useful. I'm sure you will also find it very useful. Okay, in this situation, you see the new driving, the new clutch gear here. It's a new one, the red one, which has a hollow from each side to attach the driving ring. But this is meant, or this is not meant to replace the previous version, because in the Formula One, the race car, we also got one of the old ones mixed with the new ones. So I don't really know the reasons for the choice of these helmets, because for instance here, I think it would be perfectly or could be used the older version, since it is not attached to a driving ring, unless it is useful for the B model. But seriously, I doubt that's the case, as far as I can see from the image. Okay, let's move on. Unlike the model from yesterday, this one includes two instruction books. Smaller, they are somehow more comfortable to turn the pages and to keep them open. And okay. So this 11x1x5 frame is typically an element used when we start the models to give some structure and rigidity to the model. And it certainly is the case also here. These are the structural elements of the model. You need to pay attention, for instance, here, these long pins are placed in opposite direction. So this one sticks here, and this one is, guess it is to be pushed later on in the building process. But this is the kind of details if you are not with enough attention, you are likely, or you will likely face some problems and need to rebuild something later on. Let me try to find. Okay, these gears do not intermesh here. As we can see, the image on the building instructions, it seems a bit different, but no, that's not the case. From the image, I would say that they are connected, but no, it is not the case. And here we have a big ball joint used to do the articulation of the model, most likely. Push the camera a bit forward. I think it's better like that. Okay, this goes here as a spacer, and then this one goes here, and I guess that's time to push that blue pin, right? One, and the green one also, two. So, one. Three, hell, excellent. One U joint, and these go inside the ball socket. So another long pin, and again one of these small 1L beams or ring, whatever you prefer to call it. Okay. Now a dog bone helmet, also introduced in 2014, and we are going to build the let's see, where do you see it? Not here. Okay, the range of vision is quite short in this setup, so we are going to build the gearbox or the switch box. sink. So the driving ring and another axle and another clutch gear, another dog bone and a bevel gear. Okay, now we are going to use the catch. A tow ball with axle. And again, a pin with double axle. It goes here. Okay. So we are going to apply the first stickers, one next to the switch box lever that indicates which are the functions in each position of the of this lever or changeover catch, as I think it is called at BrickLink, something like that, and another one that seems to indicate some kind of rotation, but I don't know exactly what it means at this point. Okay, we must align the driving ring in the center. More pins. And let's attach this, if I can understand how and where. Okay. I think it is like that. Okay. And now we press the pins in the bottom to get everything attached, and we need one beam here. So what do we have here? It's the switching box, some the axle that goes in or out this box, and here I think this is might be the steering or something, I don't know. We have still no visible output for the other function. And here the steering joint with this socket ball, and that's the indication that we have here. Maybe it indicates that something turns at this point. So let me just take a photo for the review later on. I should have a tripod here. But then maybe it's a bit slower. But after all, I need to take a lot of photos to be able to use one in the hand. Okay. It should be enough. And we are now moving into something else. This model uses, I think it's 21 of these new pins, so it is a very good source for them. And by the way, the only Technic set that uses them in this half. I think I've seen it being used at some other set from a different team, but I don't remember exactly what it was. Neither where I saw it. And now the other ball joint goes where is it? Ah, it is here. It was in the wrong compartment. Goes here into the other side. Oops, this is still very fragile. So we need to put some care because it requires a lot of force to not disassemble anything. Now we need one small linear actuator with a U joint, and this will connect here in the bottom, and the frame will attach at this half pin over there. Okay, so now we are going to wrap this with beams and pins. And let's see where this goes. Okay, here. And it attaches to the linear actuator from the other side. And this will close this sort of bracing. And let's reinforce it. Oops, I was moving one page ahead. So let's take some other parts that we need in between. Now we are going to attach the shock absorbers for the suspension. When there are too many pins to attach, it's not always easy. I need to do with some care to align everything. Okay. Now, more pins. So, small turntable. Okay. We are building the structure for the crane to be supported and to turn around. You see here the turntable. It uses a friction axle pin, so I guess this is to used to not let it rotate too much freely. So you kick the crane arm and it would go spinning. So this way it rotates, but just enough. So this looks very compact with a lot of gears and functions going around here, because I think we have the steering or something. Then we have one function. Where is it? I don't know. It is not this output. It is this other one that actuate maybe the linear actuator on the crane arm. And another one that will just turn the or extend the linear actuator, and I guess this is to tilt the cargo bed. So everything here in the middle looks very compact and well done. So I think it's time for another photo. Sorry. Let's move on. So this goes through the ball joints or the vehicle articulation. Well, this might not be really articulation, but the suspension. So it seems that we have this central body where the driving groups or gears suspend. But I'm still wondering whether this articulates or not. Okay. Trying to find all the necessary parts. move a bit away. And now something a bit unusual, because the designers have used two bevel gears to make something like one double bevel gear. This happens twice in this model, as we will see ahead. I think, well, this might have to do with the B model. Maybe it needs this bevel gears for the track set. So maybe that's it. This pin was not connected in place. Oops. Pop dots. Okay. So big, and I was not seeing it. And not this one, the other one, the new pin with double axle. Let me just check something. So this is what people sometimes complain, one step, one page, just to tell you that you need to push this pin. It sounds a bit too much. Okay. Okay, this is the structure for the suspension on the other side. At the moment, I don't know each side is what, but here we go. Okay, let's see if it is everything fine. Yes, it is. And okay, this is it for the moment. This is the central structure. Let's take a photo. And we are now proceeding with the driving, the axis, the rear and front axis. Now let's build one of the hexes. So we get the ball joint that goes inside the ball socket on the chassis. So we have a question from Victor. Just a moment. So Victor is asking, the double axle. Well, but Vitor is asking about what I think in terms of these two axle pins, so the double axle double pin and the pin double axle, let's call them this way, if they are both useful the same way. My feeling and from my building experience, I feel this one, the axle double pin, more useful than this one. And for one simple reason, there are more pins, there are more holes in the model than axle holes. The axle holes are not so common as holes. And it is very likely that you catch two holes in a row and then an axle pin, then the opposite. So maybe this is also the reason that why this one was released first. But as far as I've seen in this specific model, this helmet is also used a lot. I think we got 21 or something from this with this model, and only with this model so far. So this might be also very, very useful if we look the amount of times it has been used in this model. But somehow I still tend to believe that the first one will be more useful than the second one. And that's interesting, because once you use these helmets, and after some time, you don't know anymore where they were used. Okay, I see some here, and well, this is really the situation where this part is useful, because you want to connect three beams, but the beam in the middle has an axle hole. So you need to have an axle in the middle of this sort of pin. And if it is an axle in the middle, it has to be an axle at one end to go through. And then you need a pin to attach somewhere in one side or the other. Because if you use just one axle, three-stud axle, it will fix on the center beam. That's a bent beam, so it ends with an axle hole. So it will be fixed here in the middle, but not in the ends. It will be loose, like it is at one side, but not in the other. But even being loose, a bit loose at this side, I guess this will be fixed somehow later in this model. Okay, so keep going. Oh, jumping one step. It happens sometimes. I think it doesn't rest too much of these double axle pins, so I'm not sure how many I've used so far. Let me just check how many there are used in this model. I was saying 21, but yeah, it was my mistake. It is 11. So I just add 10 out of my imagination. So let's attach the wheel hubs. And then close it. Now we need four of these pin with pinhole, which is also a very useful part that I was wishing to exist for years. They were introduced in the last semester, but were not used in any of the technic sets at the time. But now they are very common in all the new technic sets. So I guess they may went into development quite late in the previous half. So there was not any more in time for the LEGO Technic designers to use them or to find soon in the designs where this could become useful, like here. So double pin without friction, or double pin, the long pin without friction, and I think these are the supports for the shock absorbers, because these parts are very useful as they can connect at strange angles, so they can rotate freely. Yeah. I get amazed with the techniques used. So let's attach this. Is it okay? Yes. Let's this ball in the ball socket. So we have here the suspension, a live axle type, if I'm not wrong. And we learn how to say click in Chinese. I never saw this before in the instructions. Can you see it? So click, click, and click. And now we need to, let me turn it to my side so I don't do anything wrong. Interesting, this suspension setup, because usually the shock absorbers are placed turned 90 degrees, so they would be able to do this, but not this kind of movement, because now they can rotate freely in this direction on the top side and also on the bottom side, and they also can rotate in this direction as we compress the suspension. It is an interesting design. So let's attach the respective linkages. Well, and now they can't move anymore sideways. So, but it happens that, unlike usually done, you see the suspension is open. So here in on the top it is spaced by 5 studs, and at the bottom size it is spaced by 7 studs, so it was required this kind of assembling. It looks interesting. So we have built one of the axles. We are now going to build the other one. I don't know which one is the first and the second, if it is the front or the rear, but it doesn't really matter at this point. By the way, still regarding the question from Vitor some time ago, let me see how many pins from one type and another. So, yeah, 11 pin with double axle and 14 axle with double pin. So also here, the axle with double pin is more common than the opposite. So Alexandra has a question. Let me see it. The Unimog and the crawler also do that with the suspension, but they have the linkage you are now assembling. I think that's called a 5-point suspension. Yeah, the suspension is the live axle. It's similar to this one. I don't remember if it was exactly like this setup or this geometry. But well, I cannot have here all the models to check and to be sure. But if it is common, it is very smart anyway. Oops. Okay. Hi, Hans. I see you have a question or a comment. Let me take a look. So we are on page 50. Okay, so you are welcome. Not that late. We have just built the central part of the chassis and the one of the suspension sides. I don't know if it is the front one or the rear. Well, now I know because it has steering in this axle, so the guess this might be the rear axle. And yes, it is, of course. I didn't thought very well about that because we have here the linear actuator that will go to tilt the cargo bed, and this one is on the back side. So this was the rear axis, and now we are building the front one. sometimes it's easy, it is just a matter of thinking a little bit. And here I am again, jumping some steps. That's what happens when we are building and doing conversation at the same time. So, by the way, let me check with the designer of this model if you have curiosity about it. Because the building techniques are very interesting. Let me do some quick check. About this. So the Arctic truck. Well, this was built by one of the newest designers. It was Aurelien Rofiange. I don't know how to spell the name, but it is not in the team for that long. I think it was already the past year. And well, let me check. Maybe 2 years ago, Aurelien. Which other models Aurelien built? He was on the construction crew with another designer and also one of the pullback models in 2014 and the motocross bike in 2013, the orange one, and well, he's already here for a few years, and the quad bike 93 92 on 2012, whoa, 2009 mini bulldozer. Okay. This was the set that he built according to my records. But let's move on. Alexandre is asking if Aurelien did create the backhoe 8069. No, that was built by Iepe. Let me just check if I'm thinking about the right model, but I think I am. Yes, that one was designed by Yep, the actual team lead for the technic designers. And okay, what I was doing. And another click in Chinese, and let's attach this and click. Okay, now we are going to attach the shock absorbers. Maybe we have something to do before than that. We are now going to fix the shock absorbers on in the bottom side. Okay. Now from the other side. Okay. You see. It's the same kind of setup than in the rear side. So it's a live axle, but it does not move sideways that much. And let's see the steering. It's working, so it has a end of gut here in the middle. This might be for the functions controlled on the switch box. Yeah, and that's what the meaning of this sticker is, just to rotate. No articulation here. My bad. And guess what? Time for another photo, because the chassis looks ready. So we are now going to use some panels. Okay, let me have this guy straight. Hi guys. Will Chandra said something? Yeah, Will Chandra is saying that the model reminds him a smaller crawler, 9398, and that's true indeed. It looks like it somehow. Just it has a lot of gearing and switchbox stuff in the middle, in the center. But apart from that, indeed, it looks like the crawler, even for the color somehow, because the crawler has a red chassis, but in the hand it has a lot of orange color all around. Sorry, I tend to be behind the model, so hidden from the camera. Yeah, Vitor is saying that it looks like a small Unimog too. Yes, because of the colors, and if we look at the when the model is finished, not at this point, I guess. Okay, so this is the structure that will attach to the linear actuator. So this is the bottom side of the cargo bed. It goes here, and oops, we need another bush. That's it. So now we have to put it in place. So we switch to the cargo bed movement, and we extend, I think that's what we are supposed to do. Let's see what comes next. Okay. And I'm not sure if I understood how it works, but let's move on and see if it really works. Okay, I thought it was going to extend more, but yes, it can't extend more, that's my doubt, but it works on the opposite way. It just pulls. It is a bit like one recent model. I think it was the container truck, if I remember it right. So time for sticker sheet. Another sticker. So more stickers, 20 to this size. Now, I think we are starting to build the fairing, the panels and so on. So there is not much to explain anymore about what's going on. But okay. Right. 21. So sticker 9, yeah, 9. And now that's sticker 6. Where is the 6? Okay. It's here. And let's attach this here, here. This goes here. So it is taking shape. Okay, we are now building the structure that will hold the cabin, as it seems. And now we are going to build the same structure for the other side. Okay, it is identical. Thank you. 22. And another sticker, number 8. Okay, Vitor has a comment. Let me just. Put this in place. Let me just finish this one here and here. And I just need one extra sticker, number 5. Okay, and let's see. Victor is asking about my opinion on the stickers of this model. Well, it is the same as for any model. I'm not huge fan of stickers because they will rest your parts unusable for other models or not easily usable. But I agree that they give another touch to the model. It looks more realistic because you can add details that you won't have otherwise, like opening doors, this full market and some lettering, some logos and so on. So it is really nice for the to see from an aesthetics point of view. But as other advantage, I noticed that the Lego has been paying some more attention with stickers to not have stickers across helmets. But another problem is that stickers with time, at least some older stickers, tend to peel off. And for instance, I had in the last exhibition that my look done, I had the Williams Formula One racer, which is quite old. It was in really good shape with the stickers stunning. And well, I think there was a bit more humidity in that area than usual, and just when the model arrived at home, I realized that the stickers were peeling off and cracking and so on. So it was not nice. I didn't really like that. So that's generally my opinion about stickers. But as I said, I agree that they give a final touch to the models that they wouldn't have otherwise. Okay. Okay, so where this, I think it's here, yeah. So the cabin is taking shape. And more stickers now. Number 12. Okay, here it is. And we have finished the first book. So let me take a photo. So we are moving in the second book. Let's hope this one to be a bit faster. We have not so many stickers to apply. Maybe this is a door. Now we are going to build the seats. It has three seats in the front, quite a lot, but that should be normal for such type of vehicles. And two spacers. The first seat. Now the two remaining seats. So each one can be adjusted individually, like this. And okay. And now we'll close the cabin from the other side. Some parts in the floor. Nothing missing. Sticker 11. 11. Where is it? Okay, 11 here. Something wrong. Let me fix this. So Alexander is asking is Alexander is asking if minifigs will fit in these seats. I don't think so, because we have just one stud here, so they will just fall apart. From a size point of view, they will probably fit, but no way to make it stable. Mm-hmm. So this front sticker has some inscription saying, I don't know if you can, AR Y 84. So it's easy to guess that this stands for Aurelian Rufiach year 84. So I guess this is the year you born or something meaningful for him. So we are going to attach the dashboard stickers. With manometers and so on. Let me switch the camera. I think you get a better view from this point. So we have the stickers, we have now the steering wheel. And that's it. It goes here on this side. Now that's time to close the cabin. From the other side. So we are done with stickers now. We get plain panels. So the cabin looks pretty nice, and not only the vehicle is quite unusual, also this cabin is really awesome. So now time to do some tubes around. Flex. Oh, so I miss something. Now the other side. Thank you. And now that's time to build the track. I don't remember the name, but the track structures. Four of them, so I hope it is not too much repetitive. Okay, two of them here, and saying that Serial replaced the tracked boogies with some wheels in his review video. Are you going to try that too? And which wheel would you prefer? Well, I must confess I didn't saw most of Serial videos yet, but I saw some comments on Herobrigs or I think on Herobrigs about that. Well, I didn't thought about it, but maybe we can try. Do you think it fits well? Because this is typically a snow vehicle, the colors and so on. So I was not seeing this differently, but did you like the result from that experiment? Yeah, that kind of balloon wheels I think should be the most suitable here. I need to check if I have some available in the drawer behind me. Just let me finish this. Okay, so Interesting. This linkage also. To do this reinforcement. Think this goes. Let me just turn the wheels the other way around. It's better this way. And let's build another one. When I look at the parts in the trays, it seems always that we are about to finish, but after all, when we think about it, we see that we still have a lot to build. So there is this one, and another two, and then the tracks, and then the crane arm. So still some time to go. Let me take a photo of this because this deserves. Okay, these both go on the same side, and then I think we should do the symmetrical ones on the other side. This is not easy. The wheel does not fit in any position, so you need to find the right position for it to fit. Now built the other two boogies. Oh, some questions. Let me just finish these elements. And look at these questions. Hans says that the results looks quite good, but it look better on the B model. Well, maybe But I like the A model as well. Maybe I like most the A model because of the intricate part in the center where the switch box goes on. I'm not sure if the B model has the same level of functions. Guess not. On my perspective, I prefer the A model. Well, I've not finished to build it yet and didn't build the B model, but this one looks really nice. Yes, about the rubber bands on the tracks. But as far as I've seen, this works well without rubber bands on some surfaces, unless you are doing it on glass or ceramics. Otherwise, for instance, in this table, it should work well, but we will see. Alexandre is saying that with the way the track bogies are attached to the hubs, it doesn't appear to be easier to motorize, even only the rear tracks. Well, the rear, yes, because on the front you do not have steering. Let me see. Yes, it won't. The way it is not. Unless we do some changes here. It's not trivial because the way until the hubs is totally blocked. So it won't be trivial for sure. But maybe there is a solution, as always. It looks that I'm getting slower at this point. A bit late, and yesterday the session was really tiring. Now I think we are getting close to the hands. And so let's attach this. So it already moves. So time for photo. No, that's time to attach. The tracks that I have here already built. I never know if there is a preferable direction to put the tracks, but let's do it as mentioned in the building instructions. Might be the safest way. Come on. So when I saw the first pictures of this model, I was not expecting this kind of steering. I was thinking it was somehow articulated, which would also work. But It looks nice. So another set of pictures. Now let's add some stuff, some accessories like some air tank or something similar. As it looks, I don't know exactly what's this. Yes, Alexandre thought that the Fortrex would steer, but definitely not, that's not the case. Just two of them. And we are finally going to build the crane arm. I think it is the last thing we are going to build for this model. So I think Hans is leaving. Okay, thank you for attending and see you next time. And bye bye. Okay, bye bye. And you can see the rest in the video tomorrow if it is worth to. So this is the rope for the crane. One. Two. And where is the hook? It's here. And now let's find how to attach this here. And to the fourth hole. Wind the rope on the reel. This is how it works. And now let's finish with some cargo. Okay, now that's time for the rear mirrors, the rear view mirrors. Okay. These mirrors are nice because they have lights built in, which is a nice detail. Nice looking antenna also. And some kind of radar maybe. Okay, and that's it. These are the spare parts. Not much. Oh, nice. One ring as spare. If I didn't miss it somewhere. And so let's test the functions. We have one the tipper or the cargo bed. And two function to raise and lower the crane arm. So it can pick the cargo. It can so let me change the camera. This way the crane is in this retracted position, but we can open it, or maybe the other way around. I do not have the hands in front, so let's close it again, and now open the crane. Now that's raised a little bit, we can extend the arm and continue to raise it. We can rotate and lower the winch. And catch the cargo. No, let's drop it gently. Well, this is, it looks, it can only drop the cargo at the edge of the cargo tray, because it cannot go, oh, can, yes, it can. Thank you. can always do it. Not very convenient, but it works. Now let's unload it. Yes, Alexandre is saying that such small crane could have a mechanism to rotate it. Indeed, even if not controlled by the switch box, maybe some knob that would allow to rotate without need to doing it manually. And that's it. It's done. Let's see if we can try the motorization. Okay, that's easy. Let's see what I'm going to need. Lights, battery box. Switch. And motor. Okay. Maybe I should switch the camera again. Sorry, I'm quite tired already. The motor. Oh, I thought I've changed the camera, but it seems I did not. Okay, first we take some lights off. And we can attach the parts here. Well, doing that here is not very a good idea, because then they will be very hard to take off again. Now we need to open this, because this is the compartment where the battery box goes. We need to connect switch. And insert the battery box and okay, switch must go somewhere. Let me see if I can do this. Now I know why the half pins went into that place. That's interesting because the battery box is, the switch is accessible from the bottom side. Now I need to put the motor somewhere. I think it is here. Let me raise the crane because it's not helping here. The axle of the motor is not aligned. Okay, it's done. Now let's pass the cable here and there, and finally it goes to the switch. And finally, the lights. This was supposed to go attached to this. Let me attach the lights and pass them through. This. This. It's not fitting properly something. Yeah. It looks, okay. The battery box was too wide. Lights here. There. And that's it. Now it's a matter of put it working. So connect the switch. Lower the arm. Raise the, oops. So it looks that when it reach the hand, something makes the arm to rotate. It's a bit weird. But now there is no space to lower the arm in this position anymore because of the switch and the power function cables, but here, okay, if we switch the function, to tilt the box, okay, and well, indeed, the Trex does not run very well in this surface. But okay. And that's it. There are not many of you still listening. I don't know if you have any questions. By the way, the steering, if you have not seen it. And I think it's quite late. I do not wish to try any tires with this, but of course, I'm sure with tires it will run smoother. Maybe for the review, I will try some tires. Okay, if you have no further questions, that's all. We have completed another model from the Technic set. Team from the Technic line with a set from the first half 2015 42038 Arctic truck. And by the way, I forgot to mention this includes some doors, and here they are to access the seats in the cabin, and of course the rear view mirrors also have the capability to rotate, and here we are, two live axles, full independent suspension. Well, not full independent, but just to live axles. So Alexander is going to sleep and I will go to sleep as well, because I should be sleeping for long ago also. I have to wake up very soon tomorrow morning. So thank you all for attending, and if you want to review something, the video will be available at YouTube tomorrow morning. See you. Bye-bye. Thank you.